Hello, I'm Laura Bree Monday. Thanks for making CN2 a part of your evening.
Good evening, I'm Lucas McFadden. Certainly glad you've joined us. First up tonight, history has been made in the town of Clover. The York County Board of Elections certainly had its hands full today.
The official results for the county and municipal races were scheduled to be discussed at 10 this morning, but one race in particular took them more than 5 hours to iron out.
CN2's Alexandria Savage joining us now with the results of the Clover mayoral election.
Preliminary results had Greg Holmes in the lead by just one election night, and since then, official results had been released saying that Donnie Grice was leading by just one. Now, since that time, there have been three recounts which have put Greg Holmes back in the lead by one vote, making history because now he is the first elected black mayor of Clover.
Very competitive race, but it definitely feels great. You know, I just had a lot of people, a lot of support from, you know, town constituents that helped me win this race.
Mayor-elect Holmes has only been on town council since March, but has worked for the town for the past 15 years and says this is the seat he wanted all along. This is one of the tightest county races in recent history. Chairman Stephen Rast, who has been on the board since 2001, says he didn't expect the results to take this long.
If it's a tie in a plurality situation, you have to do a runoff. So we've had that happen. But this, I don't think I remember anything like this since I've been on the board.
Incumbent Donnie Grice did make an appearance. He has served as Clover's mayor for the past 14 years, in the last 10 consecutively. He declined to comment on his loss. As we first reported to you Tuesday night, there will be a runoff in Fort Mill for the town council at large seat between incumbent Trudy Heemsoff and challenger Julia Beal-Smith. So make sure you go out and vote on the 21st of this month. If not, you can get your results right here in York. Alexandria Savage, CN2 News.
Really couldn't be closer. All right, Alexandria, thank you.
Holmes was also the first African-American recreational director for the town. So this is just another first for him. He also has a lawsuit active against the town, which he declined to comment on.